بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا وقائدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، all praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and peace be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I testify that there is no God except Allah, and I testify that Muhammad is the Prophet and the Messenger of Allah. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once again for making us from amongst those who get together for the sake of Allah, to please Allah and to learn more about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the beautiful verses of the Quran Kareem in the book of Allah. And in this series, we've been talking about the stories of the prophets, the beautiful and great messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent as guidance to all mankind. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَى اللَّهُ فَبُهُدَاهُ مُقْتَدِهِ. There are those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had guided. So with the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow their guidance. And we've spoken about a number of prophets and messengers. So last week we started talking about the great prophets and messengers, in which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes mention, and he says, Al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem, Ibn al-Kareem. The generous one, the son of the generous one, the son of the generous one, the son of the generous one. And there are those that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes mention, and he says, they are from amongst of the best of people. Who is the son? Who is the generous one, the son of the generous one? Yusuf alayhi salam, the son of Yaqub, the son of Ishaq, the son of Ibrahim. So we're talking about four generations. All of them are prophets and messengers. Yusuf alayhi salam, a prophet and a messenger. A son of Yaqub alayhi salam, a prophet and a messenger. The son of Ishaq, a prophet and a messenger. And then the son of Ibrahim, a prophet and a messenger. So these are four generations, and they are all prophets and messengers. The scholars say, no human being, no one, no prophet or messenger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had granted him the honor that his father, grandfather, and great-grandfather are all prophets and messengers. No one. Yusuf alayhi salam is the early one. His father is a prophet and a messenger. His grandfather is a prophet and messenger. And his great-grandfather is also prophet and a messenger. So tonight, inshallah, we'll be talking about the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. And let me say something, my brothers and my sisters in Islam. No story of any prophet and messenger came complete the way the story of Yusuf alayhi salam has been mentioned in the Quran Kareem. One full chapter, one full surah that speaks about Yusuf alayhi salam, and it speaks about the story of Yusuf alayhi salam in such details that no prophet and messenger had earned that. That doesn't mean that the other prophets and messengers, we don't have details on their life, or we don't have details on their biography or their life story, but the story of Yusuf alayhi salam came complete in one chapter. Musa alayhi salam is mentioned in the Quran Kareem more than Yusuf, but it's just scattered in different parts of the Quran Kareem. Over 73 times Musa alayhi salam was mentioned in the Quran Kareem, and his story, it's not like one story from beginning to end in one chapter. You have to find it from one verse, one chapter, one surah, one juzuh, and then you have to bring together the story. But the story of Yusuf alayhi salam from the beginning to end came all in one chapter. The only story of any prophet and messenger that came in one chapter, it came in full details in one chapter, in one surah, is the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. And Surah Yusuf alayhi salam was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in Mecca. And we all know what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam had experienced, faced, and encountered in Mecca sallallahu alayhi wasallam, him and the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, given that they were persecuted, tortured by the people of Quraysh. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam verses from the Quran Kareem to enlighten the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, entertain the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to comfort the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And that's why you realize with the suwar that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in Mecca that are there to entertain the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and to comfort him. Why? Because the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam was experiencing, him and the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they were experiencing a lot of torture, persecution, torments. They were experiencing a lot of oppression. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal verses which suit the situation. Which suit the situation. That's why when you look into the Makki verses focus a lot on the hellfire, the paradise, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised for the believers. But when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated to Medina, you find that the verses were revealed in Medina focus more on legislation. Why? Because the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has a state. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has a state. Allah's not going to talk to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about jihad in Mecca when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't even have a state. Allah's not going to talk to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about how to govern a government when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't have a state in Mecca. So you realize that we have the Makki verses and the Madani verses. Most of the stories of the prophets and messengers are Makki verses that were revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam before the migration to Medina from Mecca. And they were revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to entertain the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam and to comfort the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of them is Surah Yusuf. And some narrations say Surah Yusuf was revealed during the year of sorrow. The year of sorrow is the year that the two strongest backbone to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away in that year. Abu Talib, his uncle, and his wife Khadija. They were the two strongest backbones to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The two strongest support to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They passed away in that year. That the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself says that the people of Quraysh never managed to attack me and target me as much as they did after the death of my uncle Abu Talib. Because his wife Khadija and because of his uncle Abu Talib, and they were the two strongest supporters to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Talib was like more of a physical support and Khadija was more of a spiritual and moral support to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Surah Yusuf to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during that year to comfort the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To comfort the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, when someone is going through predicaments, when someone's going through trials, when someone's going through tests in life, the last thing that you want someone to come and drill your head in. You want someone to come and comfort you, to relax you, to tell you, you know what, have patience, inshallah things will get better. Honor someone who went through the same illness, but alhamdulillah they recovered. It's not like when you see someone that's ill, you say, you know what, the other day I met someone who had the same illness, he passed away. You know, devastate the person from the very beginning. Comfort those people. You know, the other day, there was someone in your position, or I knew someone that also encountered or had the same disease, but alhamdulillah, they recovered. You need to bring some inspiration. You need to bring some motivation. You need to bring a morale into people when they are ill, when people are experiencing hardships. Not always put people down, oh, you know what, there's no hope. You know, pessimistic people, always no hope. And that's what we have these days, especially what the Muslim Ummah is encountering. No hope at all, that's it. No, nothing's gonna happen until the Mahdi comes. That's wrong. Always be optimistic. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is implying to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to always be optimistic regardless what you are encountering, what you are experiencing, what you are facing. Be optimistic. At the end of the day, your reliance is on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one else. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Surah Yusuf, and as I mentioned, no story of any prophet or messenger was mentioned in details the way the story of Yusuf alayhi salam has been mentioned in one chapter from the beginning to the end. And that's why the most beautiful story in the Quran Kareem, obviously every single story in the Quran Kareem is beautiful, but the most beautiful story in the Quran Kareem is the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. And that's why people become very delighted and happy when they listen to the story of Yusuf. You just love listening to that story. You love listening to every single verse of the Quran Kareem, okay? Even the verses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the hellfire, you love listening to them. But the story of Yusuf alayhi salam is a very delighting, comforting, very meaningful story. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins in that chapter in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alif Lam Ra, after Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alif Lam Ra. What's Alif Lam Ra? These are the disjointed letters. What do they imply? There's a number of things, but the majority of the scholars say no one knows their meaning except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their meanings with Allah azza wa jalla, but some of them said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is implying that the Quran Kareem is made out of these letters, the language that you speak. But no one can come up with something like the Quran Kareem. Tilka ayatul kitab al mubin. These are the verses from the clear book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna anzalnahu Qur'anan Arabiyan la'allakum ta'qilun. We had revealed the Quran Kareem in Arabic, not other foreign language. It's in Arabic. He can't change it. And that's why How many Qurans do we have? You know this thing that a lot of people always say, oh, do you have an English Quran? Do you have Chinese Quran? Excuse me, we only have one Quran, that's Arabic Quran. But we have something translated in English. We have something translated in Mandarin. We have something translated in African. We have something translated in French or Spanish. But there's not such thing called English Quran. There's only one Quran. What is it? Arabic Quran. There's only one Quran. And that's an Arabic Quran. The rest are translations. Because this Quran is revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's been spoken and said by Allah in a way that suits Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the glory and the majesty of Allah azza wa jal. Inna anzalnahu Qur'anan Arabiyya. So the Quran Kareem is revealed in what language? Arabic. La'allakum ta'qilun. So you could ponder, understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to understand. You're not reading the Quran Kareem because you just want to read it. You want to read the Quran Kareem so you can understand the Quran Kareem. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins with the story of this man that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam describes it to be the generous man, the son of the generous man, the son of the generous man, the son of the generous man. And obviously, in one way or another, he's the cousin of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because Yusuf alayhi salam is from the progeny of Ishaq, the son of Ibrahim, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is from what descent? In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam is also from the progeny of Ismail, the son of Ibrahim. So, there are cousins in one way or another, but the only difference is about 2,000-3,000 years in between. But there are cousins in one way or another. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam reveals this beautiful surah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts in this chapter, in this surah, with the story of Yusuf. And as I mentioned, you're not going to find a full detailed story of any prophet and messenger in one block, in one chapter, in one surah, like the surah of Yusuf alayhi salam and the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. You're not going to find it. Musa alayhi salam is mentioned more than Yusuf alayhi salam, but the story of Musa alayhi salam is just scattered everywhere. The story of Ibrahim alayhi salam is scattered everywhere. And excuse the language if I'm using the word scattered, okay, with all honor and respect, but it's just scattered everywhere. But the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, it's in one surah. It makes it easy for you to read it from A to Z, from the beginning to end. نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ أَحْسَنَ الْقَصَصِ بِمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. We are the ones who are narrating and revealing to you the stories of the Qur'an al-Kareem. So the stories of the Qur'an al-Kareem are there and they are true, they are fact. Okay, they are factual stories, not fictional. They are true stories. Stories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention. Not wallah stories just made up. Cartoons. No, these are true stories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the nation of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. And not any story so precise. And he's talking about a gap thousands of years between Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the time of the Quran al-Kareem that was revealed to him and the time of those people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about and those nations. Where did Muhammad get precise information? Where did Muhammad get this precise information about this prophet, about this nation, about this village, about this person? From Allah. When you read the Quran al-Kareem and the stories of the Quran al-Kareem, it verifies and confirms that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam receives revelation from Allah. He doesn't make up or stage or fabricate anything from his own, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran al-Kareem, وَلَا تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْضَ الْأَقَاوِيلِ لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ ثُمَّ لَقَطَعْنَا مِنْهُ الْوَتِينِ. If Muhammad makes up anything from his own, we'll destroy him. Your beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most honorable man to tread this earth, Allah told him, if you make up anything from your own, we'll destroy you. The Quran al-Kareem is made by Allah, said by Allah, revealed by Allah, and Muhammad just conveys it. He's just a messenger. He has nothing to do with altering, amending, changing, adding, reducing. It's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نَحْنُ نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ أَحْسَنَ الْقَصَصِ بِمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَإِنْ كُنْتَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ لَمِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to Muhammad, we are the ones that are revealing the stories of the Quran al-Kareem in Arabic, even though before you didn't know of it. Muhammad didn't know the story of Yusuf, maybe heard of a prophet, his name is Yusuf, maybe, but he never knew the story of Yusuf. So where did he get the story of Yusuf from? Where did Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam get precise information about Yusuf alayhi salam? From Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jal is the one that had informed him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts with the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. Yusuf alayhi salam is the son of Yaqub. What's another name of Yaqub? Israel. So Yaqub, Jacob, Israel, Israel is one person. There are two names for one person. Two names for one person. So Yaqub is Israel, Israel is Yaqub. He's the father of Yusuf alayhi salam. I mentioned to you last week, he got married to three women. Three women. One woman, he got six kids from her. Another woman, he got four kids from her. And the third one, he got two kids and two sons from her. So he had 12 children in total. Those 12 children became later on as the children of Israel, Bani Israel. You hear a lot of them. The children of Bani Israel, the children of Israel, Bani Israel, Bani Israel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention in the Quran again, Bani Israel, Bani Israel, Bani Israel, the children of Israel, the sons of Israel. Who are the children of Israel? There's 12 sons of Yaqub, the 12 sons of Israel, Yaqub. Those 12 sons later on start to produce and procreate and produce and procreate until during the time of Musa alayhi salam, there was nearly a million of them. There was nearly a million of them. Okay. Yusuf alayhi salam had 11 siblings. Not all from the same mother, but from the same father. The only sibling they had from the same father and mother was one. What's his name? Benjamin. 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 You know, the other day someone asked me, Sheikh, is it halal for you to name someone Benjamin? And people become very reluctant because of, you know, Benjamin Netanyahu. Okay, you know what? I'll be honest with you, Islamically, there's nothing wrong with you to name someone Benjamin. But I'm telling you, he's not going to fit in the best in the Muslim community sometimes. Yeah, because the Muslim community becomes a bit reluctant. Okay, but there's nothing wrong with it. Islamically, it's like, you know, can I name my son Israel? There's nothing wrong. What's Israel? What did we say the meaning of Israel? In their language, Abdullah, the servant of Allah, in their language. But obviously, because of the tension between Muslims and the occupying country, you know, the occupiers, Israel, there's that reluctant, you know, people feel, you know, reluctant. And that's why I said it's a big mistake for people to swear Israel, because they're swearing at a prophet and messenger. It's wrong. Out of anger, obviously people don't know that, but you're talking about a prophet and messenger. And we mentioned before, and that's another point that I would like to remind you, Israel alayhi salam and the children of Israel and the prophets from Bani Israel, their race was Israeli, but their religion was what? Islam. Bani Israel were Muslims. Like how you've got a Arab Muslim, Indian Muslim, Anglo-Saxon Muslim, you've got a Pakistani Muslim, African Muslim, and it also had Israeli Muslim. That was a race. But then later on things changed and things were distorted, altered, changed, whatever it is. And that's what happened, and this is the day and age that we live in. Going back to the original people of Bani Israel, and going back to Bani Israel, the Muslims, the children of Prophet Israel alayhi salam. He got married to three women. One wife, he had six kids, the other one had four, and the other one he had two sons. Now, Yusuf alayhi salam and Binyamin, they were the only two siblings from the same mother. The rest, same father, but different mothers. And Yaqub alayhi salam, for some reason, whatever reason it is, it was very obvious to the rest of the brothers of Yusuf, because Yusuf and Binyamin were the youngest. Binyamin was the youngest, and then the second youngest was Yusuf alayhi salam. And the rest of the other brothers, the rest of the other 10 siblings and brothers of Yusuf alayhi salam, they were older than him. Some of them were probably 15, 20, even 30 years older than Yusuf alayhi salam, because they were the youngest. And Yaqub alayhi salam was very attached to Yusuf and Binyamin, to the extent that he used to favor them over the rest of the brothers. It was very obvious. He was more protective over Yusuf and Binyamin. He was always more protective over Yusuf and Binyamin than the rest of the brothers. So who picked up on that? The siblings and the brothers of Yusuf and Binyamin. So what happened here? Unfortunately, jealousy started to play. Why is our father always favoring our younger brothers? Why is our father always giving more attention to our young brothers? Why is our father always being more protective of our younger brothers? And that's why Islamically, it's haram for you to show, for you to showcase or to show that you favor one son over the other, or one daughter over the other. Even though deep inside, obviously, if you've got two sons, one of them is always listening to you, the other one is always disobeying you, by default, you're gonna love the one that listens to you over the one that disobeys you. Subhanallah, we're human beings. But you shouldn't be showing any discrimination amongst the kids. You shouldn't be showing any favoritism in front of your children. To the extent that the Prophet Muhammad SAW had forbidden that you give $100 to this son and $50 to that son. You have to be equal. Because you're going to create hostility, animosity between the brothers. You shouldn't be the one that's contributing towards the hate. You shouldn't be contributing towards the hostility between the brothers. You should be bringing together between the brothers. So unfortunately, Yaqub alayhi salam used to show too much attention and protection over Yusuf and Binyamin than the rest of the brothers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذْ قَالَ يُوسُفُ لِأَبِيهِ يَا أَبَتِي إِنِّي رَأَيْتُ أَحَدَ عَشَرَ كَوْكَبًا وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ رَأَيْتُمْ لِي سَاجِدٍ. Now obviously people sleep, and in their sleep, they see dreams. Yusuf alayhi salam one night slept and he saw a dream in his sleep. What was that dream? He says, the following day, the following morning, Yusuf alayhi salam went to his father and he said, oh father, إِنِّي رَأَيْتُ أَحَدَ عَشَرَ كَوْكَبًا. Oh dad, I saw 11 planets. I saw 11 planets and the sun and the moon prostrating to me. So Yusuf alayhi salam, one night, he saw that dream. 11 planets, the sun and the moon prostrating to him. How you thinking about, and I could even sense some people thinking, okay, the moon, the sun prostrating, bending, this and that. Allahu A'lam. He could have probably just seen those 11 planets, the sun and the moon prostrating to him. Or maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in his heart that they were prostrating to him. He doesn't know. So exactly how did the sun, the moon and the 11 planets prostrate to Yusuf alayhi salam? We don't know the details, but all we know 100% that he saw in his dream the 11 planets, the sun and the moon that were prostrating to him. Now obviously when you say 11, can you put things together? We'll leave it at the end. So Yusuf alayhi salam, one night he sees that dream. The following day, and his connection to his father, and who's his father again? His father is a prophet, a messenger, an upright, righteous man, a pious man, good man. The next morning, Yusuf alayhi salam goes to his father and narrates and tells his father about the dream that he just seen, about the dream that he saw last night. وَالْقَمَرَ رَأَيْتُهُمْ لِي سَاجِدِينَ. So I saw 11 planets, the sun and the moon, all of them prostrating to me. Who was he talking to? His father. His father is not your ordinary man. He's a prophet, messenger, wise, smart, open-minded, patient, forbearant. So what did he say to him? قَالَ يَا بُنَيْ لَا تَقْصُصْ رُؤْيَاكَ عَلَىٰ إِخْوَتِكَ فَيَكِيدُ لَكَ كَيْدًا. Yaqub alayhi salam is a prophet and messenger. If you think smart, if you think you are smart, he's smart too. He's a prophet and messenger, he's a leader. He straight away picked up on it and he said, oh my son, don't go and mention this story to your brothers. Don't go and talk to them about this dream. Yaqub alayhi salam is a prophet and messenger. He picked up that there's a future for this son of his, Yusuf alayhi salam. He knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing this young man or this young boy for something big in the future. And he's also picked up that his siblings, his older brothers, are jealous from him. So straight away, what did he say to Yusuf alayhi salam after Yusuf alayhi salam had mentioned the dream they had seen the night before? He straight away said, do not mention this dream to your brothers. فَيَكِيدُ لَكَ كَيْدًا. Then they'll start planning and plotting against you. Enough without this dream that are jealous from you. Can you imagine when they hear this dream and then they'll pick up on it? 11, what's 11? Who's 11? It's them. Son, who's the son? The father, the moon, the mother. So subhanAllah, Yaqub alayhi salam had picked up, you know, not only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed him with Yusuf alayhi salam as a righteous son, as a good son, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also preparing Yusuf alayhi salam for an honorable position and status. يا بنيا لا تقصص رؤياك على إخواتك فيكيدوا لك كيدا. Oh son, don't mention this dream to your brothers, otherwise they'll turn on you. They'll plan and plot against you. But then look at the wisdom of Yaqub عليه السلام. إن الشيطان للإنسان عدو مبين. It's not your brothers if they ever do anything wrong to you. It's the shaitan. Shaitan is the severest enemy to you. Shaitan is the worst enemy to mankind. So if you ever see something from your brothers, don't you ever put the blame on your brothers, but put the blame on the shaitan. He's trying to bring his children together. Not for them to hate each other. You know this thing, oh, you know what he said? It's because of him. No, subhanAllah. He's trying to redirect. If you ever see anything from your brothers, it's not because of them, it's because of the shaitan. And in reality, you are responsible for your actions, even if the shaitan insinuates. Even if the shaitan whispers, you are responsible for your action. But now the father, Yaqub alayhi salam, is making sure that there's no hostility, animosity between the brothers. Inna shaytana lil insani aduwwun mubin. Remember, shaitan is always working against you and against your brothers. Have you ever seen anything wrong from your brothers? From the shaitan. Don't have anything in your heart towards your brothers. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to say, وَكَذَلِكَ يَجْتَبِيكَ رَبُّكَ وَيُعَلِّمُكَ مِنْ تَأْوِيلِ الْأَحَدِيثِ. And then Yaqub continues to address his son Yusuf alayhi salam after he had seen that dream. He said to him, and that's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will choose you. Allah had chosen you. This dream alludes to an honorable position that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing you for. وَكَذَلِكَ يَجْتَبِيكَ رَبُّكَ وَيُعَلِّمُكَ مِنْ تَأْوِيلِ الْأَحَدِيثِ. You're talking about Yaqub alayhi salam. So it's not, wallahi, Yusuf alayhi salam went to some imam or sheikh or some righteous man and told him, come and interpret this dream. Yaqub alayhi salam, a prophet and a messenger, a man that receives a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen Yusuf, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also teach you the interpretation of dreams. And Yusuf alayhi salam was known for that. وَيُعَلِّمُكَ مِنْ تَأْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ وَيُتِمُّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَىٰ آلِ يَعْقُوبِ كَمَا أَتَمَّهَا عَلَىٰ أَبَوَيْكَ مِنْ قَبْلِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقِ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ. Not only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will choose you for an honorable position, not only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will teach you the interpretation of dreams, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to complete His bounty and mercy upon you and upon the children of Yaqub, the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed your grandfather and great-grandfather Ishaq and Ibrahim and Ishaq. So the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Ibrahim and Ishaq, Allah's gonna bless you too. So now Yusuf alayhi salam is being prepared. But obviously, with every good preparation, there's gotta be some tests. You can't just be prepared like that. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was prepared from the moment he was born. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born as an orphan. He wasn't born as an orphan by coincidence. It's all part of the training process. So right now, Yusuf alayhi salam has been prepared for a great position, for an honorable position. But excuse me, you're not gonna get it so cheap. Nothing comes without a price. So since you are chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then prepare yourself from now. Allah's gonna test you. It's all part of the training process. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي يُوسُفَ وَإِخْوَتِهِ آيَاتٌ لِلسَّائِلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, certainly, there was in Yusuf and the story of Yusuf and his brothers signs to those that were asking. Some of the scholars said those that were asking, لِلسَّائِلِينَ, they were the Jews who asked the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or the people of Quraysh who asked the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. These are some narrations. They've asked the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam about the story of Yusuf Alayhi Salam. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the entire story of Yusuf Alayhi Salam. إِذْ قَالُوا لَيُوسُفُ وَأَخُوهُ أَحَبُّ إِلَىٰ أَبِينَ مِنَّا وَنَحْنُ عُصْبَةٌ إِنَّ أَبَانَ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. So the brothers of Yusuf alayhi salam, the older brothers of Yusuf, all of them, the 10 brothers, beside Binyamin. So Yusuf and Binyamin, they were considered to be one party, one camp, and the other 10 brothers, the older brothers of Yusuf alayhi salam, they were considered to be one party, one camp. They all got along. It's not Yusuf and Binyamin didn't get along with them, but they were so jealous from Yusuf and Binyamin. So the 10 other brothers and the 10 older brothers of Yusuf alayhi salam, they got together. And then they said, Yusuf and his brother, they're referring to Yusuf and his brother as if his brother is not their brother, Binyamin. Because they used to look down at Yusuf alayhi salam, and they used to look down at the brother of Yusuf alayhi salam. It's like they used to marginalize them. It's like they used to isolate them. They used to isolate them. Why? Because they used to look at them as, you know, that are different. So the 10 brothers got along. Not that Yusuf and Binyamin didn't get along with the rest of the brothers, but the 10 brothers used to marginalize them. They used to isolate them. إِذْ قَالُوا لَيُوسُفُ وَأَخُوهُ أَحَبُّ إِلَىٰ أَبِينَ مِنَّا. They said that Yusuf and his brother seem to be more beloved to our father than us. It's very clear. Our father always favors Yusuf and his brother over us. They seem to be more beloved to our father than us. ونحن أصبع. Look at us, there's 10 of us. We're a lot more benefit to our father than those two young boys. We are the big boys. We are the strong boys. There's 10 of us. Why does our father continue to favor Yusuf and his brother over us? إِنَّ أَبَانَا لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. It looks like our father and dalal means misguidance. But not misguidance in deen. It looks like our father's been misguided in judgment. That's how they looked at their father. The 10 older brothers of Yusuf and Benjamin looked at their father as their father has been misguided, misjudging the situation. Why is he and why does he continue to favor Yusuf and his brother over the rest of the older brothers? He should be favoring us over them. We are the ones, when it comes to the crunch, we're going to be there because we are the strong ones. We're the fit ones. اقتلوا يوسف أو اطرحوه أرضا يخلو لكم وجه أبيك. So now amongst each other, they're talking, you know, what is this thing that our father continues to favor Yusuf and his brother? So they said, okay, simple, get rid of him. اقتلوا يوسف. Kill Yusuf. Kill him. SubhanAllah, brothers, getting together, planning and plotting against a younger brother. Not because he's done anything to them, just because their father gives him more attention than them. Uqtulu Yusuf. Can you imagine brothers getting together and say, you know what, let's go and kill our own brother? SubhanAllah. Like, you know, I understand that an older brother bullies the younger one. I understand that sometimes they push each other, but at the end of the day, when push comes to shove, man, I'm telling you, man, no one's gonna come and touch my brother. Yeah, I'll hit him, but you're not gonna hit him. I bully him, you're not gonna bully him. You know, you've got that mentality. But at the end of the day, like, you know, like, you have to have a distorted way of thinking for you to plan killing of your own brother. SubhanAllah, unfortunately, that's what the shaitan did. The shaitan started to pump him and pump him and pump him. Your brother, and look what your father's doing because of your brother. You're not getting the attention of your father because of your brother. Your father doesn't care about you because of your brother. He doesn't know what's going to happen in the future. Maybe he'll inherit all the inheritance of your father, this and that. They said, okay, we'll have to get rid of our own brother. Uqtulu Yusuf. So the older brother, his name is what? Yehuda. That's where the word Yehud comes from. So the older brother Yehuda, what did he say? He was the wisest one amongst them. The oldest one amongst them, what did he say? أَوْتْرَحُوهُ أَرْضًا يَخْلُ لَكُمْ مَجْهُ أَبِيكُمْ مَتَكُونُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ قَوْمًا صَالِحِينَ. So they planned and they plotted amongst each other and they said, just get rid of Yusuf, destroy him, strike him, take him to the ground, finish him off. And then after that, you could repent to Allah. SubhanAllah, mashaAllah. They knew they were believers. The brothers of Yusuf were believers. They were Muslims, they were believers. They had a bit of fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the biggest proof is, kill him and then repent to Allah. قَالَ قَائِلُ مِنْهُمْ لَا تَقْتُلُوا يُوسُفْ. The older one, Yehuda, what did he say? He said, no, don't kill Yusuf. What are you talking about? Killing is a major crime. It's a major sin. But just because he said, don't kill Yusuf, it doesn't mean that he wasn't in getting rid of Yusuf. He was also planning and plotting to get rid of Yusuf, but not to kill him. So what did he suggest? قَالَ قَائِلٌ مِّنْهُمْ لَا تَقْتُلُوا يُوسُفْ. The older one said, obviously the verse says, one of them said, but the narration says that one of them is the older one. The older one said, or one of them said, لَا تَقْتُلُوا يُوسُفْ. Thank you, Yusuf. وَأَلْقُوهُ فِي غَيَابَةِ الْجُبِّ. Yes, I totally agree with you. We need to get rid of him. But killing him is not an option. So, okay, what do you suggest? He said, throw him in a well. Throw him in a well. Yeah, find a well, some well, whatever it is, throw him in that well. And then what happens? يَلْتَقِتْهُ بَعْضُ السَّيَّارَةِ إِن كُنْتُمْ فَاعِلِينَ. And then one of the caravans that comes past that well will pick him up and take him somewhere. In other words, exile him, get rid of him. Exile him. Vanish him. And they knew of this well where many caravans got past. So they said, okay, let's aim for that well and go and cast and throw our brother in that well. So they've agreed, okay, we're not going to kill him, but we're going to get rid of him. How are we going to get rid of him? The way we're going to get rid of him is to throw him in that well and then let one caravan that's going past that well to pick him up and take him somewhere else. And that's exactly what they did. Okay. But there is an obstacle here. How are we going to convince our father to send Yusuf with us? There's an obstacle. They know their father. Their father is so attached to Yusuf alayhi salam and to Binyamin, they knew it's not going to be an easy ask for them to ask their father to let go of Yusuf alayhi salam for a few hours. So what did they do? They said, قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا مَا لَكَ لَا تَأْمَنَّ عَلَىٰ يُوسُفَ وَإِنَّ لَهُ لَنَاصِحٌ. They went to their father and said, oh dad, we are planning to go on a nice picnic, nice outing, want to go out, enjoy our time. Us brothers, look at us, the 12 of us, we've never spent time together. You know, give us that time and let our younger brothers, Yusuf and Benjamin, to come with us. We'll take them with us. Let them come and join us on this nice picnic or this nice outing, bushwalk, play, whatever it is. Let our brothers come with us. And the way they got and they said straight away, they knew what their father's going to say, so they preempted that. And they said to their father, oh dad, why you never trust us with our father, or with our brother? Why don't you ever trust us with Yusuf alayhi salam? Why don't you ever let go of Yusuf and let Yusuf join us? You never trust us, huh? You know when you want to make someone feel guilty? Oh, you know what? You're not going to lie. Look, what's the point of me even talking to you? It's like you come up to someone and say to him, look, I want to tell you something, but you know what? Don't worry about it. They told me, what's the point? If I'm going to tell you, you're not going to believe me. Straight away, you've cornered someone. That's exactly what they've done to their father. Oh dad, we want to go out on an outing, but we want to take our younger brothers with us, Yusuf and Benjamin. But you know what? You're not going to trust us anyway. Why? مَا لَكَ لَا تَأْمَنَّا عَلَىٰ يُوسُفُ وَإِنَّ لَهُ نَصِعُنَا. We care about our brother. He's our brother at the end of the day. We care about him too. قَالَ إِنِّي لَيَحْزُنُنِي أَن تَذْهَبُوا بِهِ أَرْسِلُوا مَعَنَا غَدًا يَرْتَعُ وَيَلْعَبُ وَإِنَّ لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. So they said, oh dad, send him with us tomorrow. We're planning to go on an outing, on a nice picnic. Send him with us so he could join. He could enjoy himself. He'd join us, play with us. And we'll be very protective over him. Don't worry, he's our younger brother. We'll take care of him. قَالَ إِنِّي لَيَحْزُنُنِي أَن تَذْهَبُوا بِهِ وَأَخَافَ يَأْكُلَهُ الذِّئْبُ وَأَنْتُمْ عَنْهُ غَافِلُونَ. So the response of the father was, that I'm afraid that if I let go of him, or if I let him go with you, that while you are playing, the wolf will come and eat him and kill him. So they said, قَالُوا لَئِنْ أَكَلَهُ الذِّئْبُ وَنَحْنُ عُصْبَةٌ إِنَّ إِذًا لَخَاسِرُونَ. Are you for real, dad? Seriously? Can't you see of us, 10 of us? There's 10 of us here. You think that the wolf can come and strike our brother and there's 10 of us? Come on, dad. Are you for real? So they start to corner their father. To end under a lot of pressure on their father. The father to end gave in. So what did they do the following day? They went out on this outing and they took their younger brothers with them and they took him to that well. They knew that a lot of caravans go past that well. Some narrations say along the way, what were they doing? They were pushing Yusuf alayhi salam, insulting Yusuf alayhi salam, slapping Yusuf, bullying Yusuf alayhi salam, and Yusuf just keeping it in him. Yusuf alayhi salam is keeping it in him. And then فَلَمَّا ذَهَبُوا بِهِ وَأَجْمَعُوا أَن يَجْعَلُوهُ فِي غَيَابَةِ الْجُبِّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says when they went and they all agreed to throw him in the well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْهِ لَتُنَبِّئَنَّهُمْ بِأَمْرِهِمْ هَذَا وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. So they grabbed Yusuf alayhi salam and they threw him in that well. And then they took the shirt of Yusuf alayhi salam, slaughtered a sheep, and they stained the shirt of Yusuf alayhi salam with a lot of blood. And then they went back to their father, crying. وَجَاءُوا أَبَاهُمْ عِشَاءً يَبْكُونَ. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? Allah azza wa jalla says, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْهِ لَتُنَبِّئَنَّهُمْ بِأَمْرِهِمْ هَذَا وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. Allah revealed to Yusuf alayhi salam. At that moment, Allah inspired him. One day, you're going to remind your brothers of this time. Another narration says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel to carry him from not falling to the ground. Allah protected him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comforted Yusuf alayhi salam, telling him, one day you're going to remind your brothers. Which means what? One day you're going to be reunited with your brothers. Now they got rid of you, but one day you're going to see them. One day you're going to meet them. And not only meet them, you're going to remind them of this moment. What they've done to you. The plan and the plot that they planned against you. And then they returned back to their father with a shirt of Yusuf alayhi salam stained with blood. وجاءوا أباهم عشاء يبكون. They return back to their father crying, dad, dad. And Allah Azza wa Jalla even mentions the time in the evening. وجاءوا أباهم عشاء يبكون. They return back to their father in the evening crying. قالوا يا أبانا إن ذهبنا نستبق. Oh dad, while we're racing, playing, and we left Yusuf alayhi salam, we left Yusuf our brother behind, looking after our luggage and looking after our stuff. The wolf came and attacked him. And look, this is the big proof. That's his shirt. وما أنت بمؤمن لنا ولو كنا صادقين. Straight away they wanted to preempt it, and they said, even if we are honest, you're not going to believe us. Even if I'm correct, you're not going to believe us. Even if I'm right, you never believe me. You know this thing, your kids, oh, even if I'm right, no, even if I'm right, you're not going to believe me. Straight away, put in a corner. So Yaqub alayhi salam looked into the shirt of Yusuf and he said, Subhanallah, how merciful this wolf. This wolf ate my son and did not even rip that shirt. How merciful is this wolf? He ate the flesh and broke the bones of my son and left his shirt untouched. Intact. Allahu Akbar. قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا. This is from the shaitan. This is what you desire, wanted. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ. I'm going to be patient for the sake of Allah. وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that we depend on over what you just mentioned. I'm going to go back to Allah. I'm going to return back to Allah. This is the big test. Imagine the most beloved son to you. Not only a son, an obedient son, well-mannered son, good-looking son, and a future to be prophet son. And what was the reaction of Yaqub alayhi salam? فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ. Good patience. Beautiful patience. I'm going to be patient for the sake of Allah. And now where's Yusuf? Where's Yusuf? In the world, stuck in the world. What happens there? And what happens then? We'll talk about it next week. Subhanakallah bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa atubu. We'll talk about the next phase and next part of Yusuf alayhi salam while Yusuf alayhi salam is in the world and after the world.
Some dreams to be up in Jannah. It pies person's destiny. Inshallah, in Jannah.